knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
Throughout this series, we have discussed many facets of mineralogy, such as structures, classification, and formation. Now it's time to go into more depth regarding one process in particular, weathering. All sedimentary rocks are formed through weathering, a combination of different forces and conditions that break down rocks exposed at the surface into smaller fragments. Geologists divide weathering into two categories, physical and chemical. Physical weathering is the collection of processes that break down rocks mechanically. More simply, one big rock becomes many small rocks. By contrast, chemical weathering involves the chemical alteration of minerals, including acid-base reactions, redox reactions, and dissolution. We will now discuss physical weathering, which greatly accelerates chemical weathering by breaking rocks into smaller pieces and increasing the surface area available for chemical reaction. There are many mechanisms of physical weathering that operate in different climates. For example, in temperate areas of the world that experience freezing winters, the freeze-thaw process is the dominant process. Because ice has a 9% greater volume than liquid water, when any pre-existing void in a rock, such as a fracture, fills with water which later freezes, the expansion of the water applies a force that is on the order of 1 kilobar, or around 15,000 psi, which pushes outward in all directions and creates new fractures. In arid regions of the world, the growth of secondary minerals in fractures, such as gypsum or other salts, has a similar effect to the freezing of water we just mentioned. Tropical environments do not experience much physical weathering. However, they have intense chemical weathering due to abundant precipitation and high temperatures. Physical weathering also has a biologic component. For example, the growth of tree roots into small rock openings can widen and open them into larger fractures. The branching root-like hyphae of fungi have a similar effect. The burrowing of animals, like moles, can bring fragments of rock to the surface, where they are chemically weathered more rapidly. Though not considered weathering, the formation of regular sets of joints, or extensional fractures, in bedrock greatly accelerate the weathering process. All rocks contain fractures, which form in aligned perpendicular fashion to its least compressive stress. It is common for a geologic formation to form regularly spaced sets of joints as it is being uplifted to the surface, and the stress field changes from a state of horizontal compression to horizontal tension as the lithostatic pressure, or pressure from surrounding rocks, is reduced. These joints tend to be perpendicular to the surface and occur in sets of two at around 90 degrees, though they can be much more complex. Next time you are driving along the highway, notice how nearby rocks are broken along planar surfaces, forming a step-like pattern. That is not the work of humans, but of Mother Nature. At any rate, joints provide starting areas for the other mechanisms of physical weathering to operate, and since they're often filled with groundwater, they make great areas for thirsty tree roots to enter in search of water. With physical weathering covered, let's move forward and take a look at chemical weathering next.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.